for hackers, breaking into a computer is like climbing Mount Everest.
Did they break in because they could? I think that's a lot of it. They saw an opportunity and they said, well, I could do this, or I could wait for somebody else to do this. If I do it, I'm going to get the attention for it.
But the thing about hacking is, it's like trying to sell stolen artwork. Fred Evans with First Tech Computer says it's hard to profit without getting caught.
I think sometimes these guys don't think it all the way through.
On Tuesday, federal prosecutors in New Jersey charged Daniel Spitzler and Andrew Ornheimer with conspiracy and fraud for stealing 120,000 email addresses of iPad users who subscribe to AT&T.
The code that they used, which was written by Spitzler, was called a slurper, and it was designed to mimic the behavior on iPad so that AT&T servers were fooled into believing that they were communicating with an actual iPad.
But what to do with the information? The FBI seized instant messages between Spitzler and Ornheimer discussing everything from selling the list for spam to manipulating AT&T's stock. In the end, they took the path of many hackers, simply bragging about the hack while embarrassing AT&T for a lack of internet security.
The hallmark of this criminal hacker subculture is malicious one-upsmanship.
And for hackers, Apple was a big prize because of its relatively secure operating system. But it was actually AT&T that left themselves vulnerable.
If you're giving a large corporation your information and they don't secure the information, well, there's not much you as an individual can do about that.